Hi everyone, we cannot change our personality type, we cannot change how we are wired and programmed, we cannot change our preferences, what makes us happy and stressed, our fear and aspiration, what we like and don't like, our way of thinking, perceiving and deciding, our way of dressing or behavior. We cannot change our natural energy. If we could change our personality, that means we also change our identity, name, birth date, birthplace, genetic, DNA, physique, because all of these are connected, mind and body are two sides of the same entity and function together. We cannot change our personality type and personality, we do this instead. Our life consists to discover, understand, know and accept our authentic self, our essence, our real nature, and knowing ourselves is not innate. We are not born with a manual, we have a sort of like, write the manual. We learn about ourselves during all our life. During our life on the external world, we do experience, we learn, we discover new things, new person, and by comparing, judging, we try to find what corresponds to us and what's not, what we like and what we don't like. We try to determine the person and the thing which are aligned with us or not. We keep what corresponds to us and let go what doesn't correspond to us. We will not find ourselves if we search outside. We find ourselves when we search inward. But we need the information of the external world to know the internal. We need both the inner world and the outer world to know ourselves. With the time we discover ourselves, our true and authentic self, we become more aware, we have more conscious of the unconscious. Little by little, over time, the conscious seeks the information in the unconscious and breaks into the surface. In the conscious, we bring the deeper part of ourselves to the surface, and it's done with the function intuition, which have access to the deepest layer of the unconscious. But it's not magic and not automatic. We need the information on the outside to trigger the information in the unconscious. Our life consists to develop, grow our consciousness, to having conscious of the unconscious, and therefore having conscious of the unconscious part of ourselves, to bring to the surface our root, our natural and authentic self, all the part of ourselves we repress during our life, by trying to adapt to other people, by trying to adapt to society, by trying to protect ourselves, by trying to don't show our vulnerability and weaknesses, by fear to be hurt, by fear to be judged and not accepted for who we really are, we have to accept we are unique. In a recent video, Dario Nardi said, "I do believe people return to the root of their type when they get much older. I think we can return to the root of our type much earlier when we take time with ourselves, when we spend time lonely by reflecting, with introspection and meditation for example. I think certain personality types or persons are more chance to discover their authentic self earlier than the other due to their natural awareness, introspection and curiosity, or their obsession to know and improve themselves, like the INTJ for example. With the time we improve, we update our way of thinking, perceiving and behaving, we learn and know more things, we become more conscious, wiser, more responsible. We evolve, grow, discover things about ourselves we were not aware of it before, we get closer to our authentic self, we return to our natural state, if we can say so. We also adapt to people and situations by using alternatively one of the four sides or part of our personality type. To be efficient with our lower function, we need to put more energy, effort, concentration and time into them. It can be draining. We use naturally the four sides of our personality without being aware of it, and so our lower function, when we are emotional, happy, angry or other emotion, when we stress and not naturally, if we consume medication, drug or alcohol, I explain it in detail in my video on the four sides of the mind. We need this part to survive, adapt and protect ourselves. Most of the time, globally, when we don't stress, we use 98% of our function and 10% of our last function, or it could be 80-20, even if it's more complex because we are all different and unique and we have different layers in our personality. I already made a video on it too, on the different layers of our personality. To come back to the conscious and unconscious, an image to better explain is an hourglass shape. Sort of like when we are child, the unconscious is much bigger than the conscious, and with the time, the conscious seek and break the unconscious, which is deep to the consciousness, which is the surface. The unconscious becomes conscious, and our entire personality is integrated. We are our authentic self or true nature. Globally is when we take conscious, accept we are unique and different, when we accept our weaknesses and strength. It's just my perception, and it's also the perception of many other people. Imagine this side is the unconscious and this side is the conscious. When we are a child, our conscious is little and over time it develops and grows. And depending on the person, how the person grows, his conscious can stay little, the person is not very aware, or the person can develop and his conscious with the time is more and more big. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.